Welcome to Paul Carney Arts, and in this lesson I'm going to show you how to shade a cube. The lessons we've done so far have focused on how to shade, and now what I'd like to turn your attention to is where do we put the dark shade in and where do we put the light shade in order to make things look realistic. And to be able to do this, you need to understand a little bit about light and how light affects objects. I want you to imagine there is a light shining on that cube. I'll draw a little lamp like that. Well, what would happen is the side that's closest to the light would get the most light. And so we would use very light shading. Sometimes no shading at all on the surface that's closest to the light. And on the side that's furthest away from the light, we would shade that our darkest shade in, because we say that's in shadow. That leaves us one side left. And on the side that we have left, we would shade it middle shading, because that's getting a middle amount of light. It's not the lightest, it's not the darkest. There. Now that looks more like 3D. And we can make it look even better by putting our cast shadow. And that means the light is shining onto the cube and it's creating a shadow on the surface of the table. Now, a cast shadow is important. You've got to get it right. Where the object hits the table, it has a very dark edge, almost like a thick line. And that's important. It's basically where the cube is touching the table. You get this very thick, dark line. And then you can shade dark shade and your darkest shade in on top of that, and it's dark the closer it is to the object, and then it gradually fades out and gets lighter the further away, because the light's having less effect on it. So you need to blend that in so you don't see where it's gone dark and light. And that uses the technique that we've learned before about shading from light to dark. And this technique is using the solid shading that we learned. And now that looks more 3D. We could actually make it look even better by putting some background in. Just a little bit of background would help it look even more solid. Yeah, because we've created depth now. If we've made that look like it's far away in the distance, and then therefore it looks even more 3D. What would happen if the light changes to there? And what would happen if the light changes from the opposite side? Have a go then at doing this yourself. And try to copy this exercise and then try to complete it.